As an expression of our commitment to recognize the leadership of non-state actors and their support to Paris on the fulfillment of the existing obligations under the Convention and the Kyoto Protocol, we are launching today the NAZCA portal, the non-state actor zone for climate action, that we are sure will be a very important tool to be engaging in our ambitions and to show what we are able to do for the people, for the citizens, for the present, and toward the future. Thank you very much.
Here at the COP in Lima, it's what we're calling Lima Climate Action Day. And what is happening is a showcasing of many of the interesting actions that are happening around the world, in the real world, in terms of dealing with climate change. Now, as a contribution to Lima Climate Action Day, there's a new portal that's actually been launched. It's an initiative of the Peruvian government, supported by the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change. And this portal is actually capturing and showcasing the sheer wealth and breadth of what's happening in cities around the world, what's happening in terms of climate investments around the world, and what's happening in companies around the world to actually generate ever more climate action. And this portal is named after those famous lines in the Peruvian landscape, the Nazca lines, and we're using that symbolism to inspire ever more action by what we call non-state actors.
A lot of our work is with investors. We work on behalf of nearly 800 investors who are managing about $92 trillion of assets. And through our platform, on their behalf, 5,000 plus companies disclose what they're doing about climate change, how it's impacting them, what their emissions are, and what their strategies are. And so we're sitting on a mass of data about how these non-state actors, businesses, cities and regions, see the challenges of climate change and the bold actions that many of them are already taking.
Many cities have already said by 2050 they want to reduce their emissions by 80%. It's going to mean that we're not going to build energy behemoths that leak energy. We're going to build buildings that use energy properly. The cities are saying, don't wait till 2020 to implement. Let's put a plan in place for 2015. We can do it. We don't need to wait. It's time to do it now.
So please join me to introduce Mr. Former Vice President of the United States, Al Gore.
Information technology, again, gives us the means to harvest the enormous opportunities represented by that inefficiency. All of the lights in every building can be connected to sensors that are very cheap, which can then communicate with one another over wireless networks and eliminate the electricity costs for lighting when people don't need them. The same thing can be done with heating and air conditioning. The same thing can be done with every technology that uses energy. We're talking about 50, 60, 70, 80, and even 90% savings in category after category. The tools are available.
The global energy market of the future is poised to be the largest market the world has ever known. This is an opportunity to put millions of people to work, building the infrastructure, doing the transition, and pulling us back from this brink. We can find a way to summon the shared resolve that we need to tackle this shared threat. And if we do that, then we will reach an agreement. We will meet this challenge. That is our charge, and for the sake of our children, our grandchildren, and our responsibility as human beings on this earth, this is a charge we must keep. Thank you very much.